Food is wasted in many places around the world every day, and that waste is piling up. It's becoming increasingly important for our world to find sustainable ways to manage food waste and reduce the size of landfills. Composting is a method that can be used to reduce food waste. Compost is decomposed organic material, such as food scraps, yard waste, and livestock manure. By sending organic waste to landfills, we damage valuable resources. When we save these materials to produce compost, farmers and gardeners can reuse the material to enhance the soil used to grow our food. The Lincoln Public School System in Nebraska is working to teach youth about the importance of protecting our environment. It is estimated that Lincoln adds approximately 7 pounds of waste per capita to a landfill every day, and 17% of that waste is food. More than 13,000 students in 22 Lincoln Public Schools are composting organic waste from their cafeterias. Students are learning what waste is, how to reuse it, and what their role is in helping create a more sustainable earth. The students gain hands-on experience sorting out their foods in the cafeteria. One lesson is comparing sizes of food waste in items to better understand how to shrink landfills. In addition to food composting, new trash cans with larger bins for recycling and smaller bins for waste have been placed throughout the school. This is to adjust students' thinking about recycling versus waste, to place emphasis on sustainable practices. So where does the organic food waste from LPS go? The school district is partnering with Prairieland Gold, a composting operation managed by Prairieland Dairy outside of Lincoln. Prairieland Gold is one of the few operations in the area with the size and ability to take the amount of waste produced by the schools. Their compost is created by combining organic wastes in proper ratio piles and rows. Then, the rows must have controlled temperature, moisture, and oxygen to accelerate the decomposition process. The piles are strategically turned periodically to allow oxygen and moisture to assist the breaking down of the plant matter. Naturally occurring microorganisms decompose the organic material. The compost serves as food and energy for the microorganisms. Temperatures reach 110 to 150 degrees for this to occur, and when the temperatures decrease, the pile goes through a curing period of 2 to 6 months. Mature compost can be sold to both the farmer and the gardener to spread on their plots and fields to enhance the growth of their crops. The use of compost has a number of benefits, including soil structure improvement, nutrient and water holding capacity, and more. Without a compost program, organic waste from schools is sent to the landfill. When organic material is trapped in the anaerobic conditions of a landfill, it produces a harmful greenhouse gas called methane. By keeping food waste out of the landfill, we minimize the production of methane and turn waste into a valuable product. Lincoln Public Schools estimates its composting efforts have prevented 508,256 pounds of organic waste from going to a landfill. That's a 52% reduction per capita of waste going to a landfill. The small changes they've made in the cafeteria and classroom are adding up to huge positive gains for our environment. Next time you go to throw away trash, don't forget to consider where the trash is going. By making a small daily habit to recycle and compost more, we make a large impact to preserve the world around us. Start the sustainability conversation and see what impact you can have on your local area.